Hey, Gabby.
What's up?
Gabby?
Hello?
No! Michael, I was just having the best dream ever.
Whoops, my bad. Gabby, anyway, it's not even time for daydreaming. It's time for week two of CF Kids Christmas.
You don't understand. I was at the Christmas Eve Spectacular Bake Off and I was about to be named the Gingerbread Champion of the World.
Gabby, there's not going to be a bake-off in the Christmas Eve Spectacular.
Huh. Well, there might be. And if there is, I know just how it will go. Okay, on second thought, Michael, you're right. There probably shouldn't be a bake-off at the Christmas Eve Spectacular, but if we aren't baking anything, then what yummy treats will we have?
Well, it's funny you should ask, actually. Kern has the perfect game to help us find the perfect Christmas treat.
Hey CF Kids, joining me for today's game is Michael. Michael and I are gonna be tasting different candy canes flavors and trying to identify what they are. Now Michael, please select our candy cane.
Hey CF Kids, it's time for another Christmas fun fact. Did you know that candy canes are actually a perfectly sweet way to tell others about Jesus? The white on the candy cane represents how Jesus makes us clean. The red stripes represent his blood that was shed for our sin. The shape of a candy cane is a reminder that Jesus is a good shepherd and takes care of us. Still not convinced? Well, I'll help you out. Flip your candy cane upside down and you have a J for Jesus. Told ya! Share a candy cane and share your faith. Back to the game.
All right. I hope there's no spicy ones here. But I was thinking the original ones. Right, I forgot to brush my teeth, so I hope these are minty fresh.
Yeah, me too.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. I think.
Sweet. You like cherry?
Vanilla, maybe? No, cherry.
I think they're cherry flavored. I'm gonna say they're cherry flavored candy canes.
Yeah.
Root beer?
Wow.
What? Okay, I dig it. You know, I'm not a fan of root beer, but I dig this.
I haven't had root beer in ages. All right, next candy cane.
Let's do it. I'm gonna save this for later.
Let's do the black and white ones.
Black and white.
Yep. All right.
Oh, this one's broken. I'll take this one.
That means you gotta eat the whole piece.
What is this?
There's chocolate.
Nice. Oh, that's
what that
is.
Even though it's black, but I think it's chocolate.
Could it be like
You know, this actually tastes like root beer.
No, this is like either a s'mores flavored or like a chocolate milk.
Oh, chocolate milk. So I did say chocolate.
I think it's s'mores.
Look, there's chocolate in his lips.
Is there?
All right, so what is it?
All right, so s'mores. I say s'mores.
I say chocolate.
Oreo?
What?
All right, well, it wasn't bad. Yeah. It wasn't bad at all.
Okay.
Saving that one for later,
you
too.
You choose the next one, Michael.
Banana. We'll go with this banana flavor. Banana looking one.
You know banana is my favorite.
Let's do it.
All right. Wait.
I have no idea what this tastes like.
Because of the Oreo, I no longer have taste in my mouth. Maybe you should smell it. It smells like Oreo.
No, it smells like plastic. What?
I think this is a bland flavor, if there's a such thing.
No.
You taste it?
No. This is popcorn. This is popcorn flavored.
Popcorn, I'm gonna say yellow butter.
Very, very cheap popcorn flavor, but it is popcorn. I wanna say it's popcorn.
Okay.
It reminds me of the jelly bean popcorn.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And the flavor is...
mac and cheese?
Yeah.
What?
Oh, this does not taste like mac and cheese.
No. Michael, let's go with the green.
The green?
This actually looks a little peppermint, you know, because...
All right. Maybe it's pistachio.
You kind of need it, remember?
Yeah.
I'm trying to bite.
What is this?
Wait.
What is this? This is crushing.
This one smells weird. This smells like...
What is it?
You know those weird jelly candy? It's a game. Man, I can't... Kids, this... No.
I don't want to taste anymore.
I don't want to taste anymore, Michael, please. You tell them.
I have no idea what this is.
Dill pickle! I knew it! I knew
this
it!
This is so gross.
That's why I stopped.
I hate dill pickles.
Pick the next one. Pick the next one. And you swallow a piece of the last one.
Mm. I actually took a bite of it. All right, let's go with this orangey, innocent looking candy cane.
Maybe this one let's is, see. You know.
Maybe it's like a strawberry banana.
Smell it first, Michael. You've been...
Oh my gosh, what is this?
I lost my sense of smell.
This is weird. Oh, wait a minute.
Nope. No.
It's like pepperoni.
No, this is not. Why? This is not okay. This is not okay.
Okay, this, it's spicy. It's tangy. I don't even know how to describe it.
It smells like, it tastes like pepper.
Wait a minute.
There's pepper in there.
This is disgusting. Take a bite of it. Take a bite of it. Come on, there you go.
Michael, there you go.
Mm-mm. It's horrible.
I will not swallow it, but it tastes like...
It's like basil.
Pepper. Yeah, like paprika.
Like condiments. Mm. It tastes like condiments. Like straight up, like if you put a bowl of condiments together, that's what you get.
Kids?
What do you think of it?
I don't know.
I think it's a bowl of condiments.
Okay. I think it's maybe...
Paprika?
Probably some seasoning mixed together. This is what it tastes like.
Pizza? No way!
Listen, if I ever have to order this pizza, never.
Let's just say there's better pizza out there.
Mm. All right.
All right, we got one more. Let's do it.
Please let this be an original.
At this point, we need a minty fresh.
Yes.
Let's do it.
All right.
Okay.
Still can't smell nothing.
Bad. It still smells, they all smell like plastic.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
Okay.
I like this one.
Strawberry. I think there's strawberry in there.
No, this is cherry. This one is cherry.
This one is cherry?
This one is cherry for sure. Cherry pop.
I had cherry last night and I don't know.
Like real cherries?
Like real cherries, Michael.
All right, nothing ever tastes like real cherries.
I think this one is, I'm gonna say vanilla.
This one's cherry. I'm going for cherry. What are you going for?
Vanilla ice cream.
Vanilla ice cream. Strawberry lemonade.
What?
That not taste like strawberry lemonade.
Not even.
All right, let me get some water, please.
Please, please.
Thanks.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my bad. Yeah, here you go.
Thanks. Wow, need to wash all of this seasoning and flavor in my mouth.
Ah, that was horrible. Wow. That pizza one was disgusting.
Mm.
All right.
Not good. I hope you guys enjoy watching Michael and I taste these weird candy canes.
Yeah.
You guys will not want to be here. But this was fun.
This was fun, Kern. Thank you for inviting me, bro. Oh,
hey, my pleasure.
Hey-o!
Hey, CF Kids. In case you missed it, last week we discovered that when God says he will do something, we can believe him. A priest named Zacharias was visited by an angel. The angel told him that his wife Elizabeth would have a son, and they should name him John. Because Elizabeth was so old, Zacharias didn't fully believe the angel, and his doubt had a consequence. God took away Zacharias' ability to speak. When Elizabeth finally did have her baby, Zacharias wrote down that his name would be John. Suddenly, Zacharias got his voice back and he praised God. John would be used by God to prepare the way for Jesus. For Zacharias, having a baby at such an old age seemed impossible. But as we are about to find out, God can do anything. Check this out.
There's a story in the Bible where we see that God can do anything. It's about a young girl who was living in the town of Galilee. Her name was Mary, and she was engaged to a man named Joseph, but they weren't married yet. One day, while Mary was alone, God sent an angel named Gabriel to give her a message. You see, God had something amazing that he wanted to do in Mary's life. The angel said, "Greetings, the Lord is with you. You are very special to him." But Mary was very confused about what the angel said. She wondered, "What does this mean?" Gabriel said, "Don't be afraid, Mary. God is very pleased with you." Then he told her how she would become pregnant and give birth to a son, and that she would name him Jesus. Jesus would be great and be called the Son of the Most High. Mary wondered how she could have a baby when she wasn't even married, but Gabriel explained it all to her. Gabriel said, "The Holy Spirit will come to you, and the power of the Most High God will cover you." He went on to tell her that the baby would be holy and be called the Son of God. That wasn't all, though. There was even more good news. Gabriel also told Mary that her cousin Elizabeth was pregnant. Even though Elizabeth was very old, she was going to have a son too, because God can do anything. Mary trusted God and said, "I am the servant of the Lord. Let this happen to me as you say." Then, just like that, the angel went away. Mary got up and went quickly to a town close by to see Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary was there, she ran to meet her and said, "Mary, God has blessed you more than any other woman, and he has blessed the baby to which you will give birth. When I heard your voice, the baby inside me jumped with joy. You are blessed because you believed that what the Lord said would really happen." It was true. Mary believed God could do anything. Mary began to sing a song praising and thanking God for what he had done. She could have been afraid or worried when the angel gave her this news, but she knew that everything would be just fine because God can do anything.
Michael, this part of the story always amazes me. Out of all the girls, God chose Mary to be Jesus' earthly mother. Why do you think that is?
Well, Gabby, just look at how she responded to the angel Gabriel. She didn't doubt like Zacharias did. Although she didn't understand how it would happen, she trusted that it would happen. She knew that God could do anything.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure Mary was confused and maybe even a little nervous.
For sure. But Mary was young and she wasn't even married yet. But she believed in God and decided to trust in him anyway.
And what would happen next is a miracle, right?
Correct, Gabby. Now, a miracle is something that only God can do. And as we have been learning today, nothing is impossible for God. And through the work of the Holy Spirit, Mary became Jesus's earthly mother.
Mary believed God when she received the most amazing news that Jesus would be born to her.
Mary worshiped God for the rest of her life, and we can worship now too. Join us, CF Kids, as we sing praises to God.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive the King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
Joy stop.
Christmas worship songs are my favorite because they remind me that God can do anything.
Now, our memory verse for this month reminds us of just that. Let us give thanks to God for His gift. It is so great that no one can tell how wonderful it is. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 15. And now I've been working on this memory verse so hard, and so have the rest of the gang, I hope. But here is another week of our dessert decorating competition.
Hey, CF Kids, welcome back to another week of our memory verse game, Holly Jolly Kitchen Competition. Last week, Gabby came through for the win and got to choose a prize from our wall of gifts for this month's mystery prize. We have had some excitement, fun, and lots of delicious decorating, but we aren't stopping there. This week, we're gonna turn it up more with some gingerbread houses. Now, let's welcome back our competitors. Introducing from the snowy Hayo mountaintops, Sir Michael.
Heyo! This week is my week, guys.
All right. Next, we have the lover of peppermint mochas, Miss Gabby.
Gingerbread houses are my favorite.
And our last competitor, none other than the collector of candy canes, Sir Kern.
You can't spell winner without Kern. Come on.
Hey, bro. I know you're really hyped up, but you can actually spell winner without Kern.
I agree. That sounds a little off.
Guys, come on, we'll talk about this later.
So glad to have you all playing again with us this week. Before we begin, our dessert experts are back. Say hi, judges.
I'm so glad to be here.
I'm just here for candy.
Hello.
Kids watching, just a reminder that our memory verse comes from 2 Corinthians 9:15. It says, "Let us give thanks to God for His gift. It is so great that no one can tell how wonderful it really is." Now, this week we'll be focusing on the second part of the memory verse, and it says, "It is so great that no one can tell how wonderful it really is." Competitors, you will have 3 minutes to decorate your gingerbread cottages using these materials. Good luck, everyone. Are you guys ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. One. Hands off your gingerbread houses, competitors! All right, guys, that was an intense one, and you have some really cool gingerbread cottages going on. How are you guys feeling?
Listen, guys, this is mine. All this hard work, the sweat, I really put my foot in this one.
I hope your feet nor the sweat are in the actual gingerbread house. Let's kick it over to our judges and see this week's winner.
Okay, let's start off with Michael's.
You know, I don't know what the judges will say about my house this week. It looks like a deconstructed Christmas tree. It's weird, but it's all in the judges' hands.
This looks very, very artistic, like a deconstructed Christmas tree.
Guys, it has my favorite color. Do you see it? Do you see it? It's pink. I love pink. I just love pink.
I like this one and the cool North Pole.
My favorite ingredient this week to work with was the candy cane, although I didn't really know what to do with it, so I just put it as a North Pole candy cane.
Next is Gabby's.
My biggest struggle this week was matching the gingerbread house to the verse. What is that? It's so great that no one really knows what it is. It's true, God's gift is, but my gingerbread house did not match it. So I think that was for sure my biggest struggle for this week.
Oh, Gabby, but why?
No, no cry.
What does the gummy bears do to
you?
No,
no, no. It's not time out. Look, friend.
Cause I'm a gummy bear. Cause I'm,
you know, look. And it has pink. My favorite color.
I like the gummy bears because they're really colorful.
So I think this week the judges might be a little bit confused with my gingerbread house. I was trying to make it confusing, you know, like you don't really know what's inside of it. But I think they're gonna think it's a timeout box for gummy bears.
And whoa!
I feel extremely confident. I mean, the verse says no one really knows what it really is. And I think my gingerbread house, no one's gonna know what it is.
Kern, this is absolutely spectacular. I've never seen something like this before.
This reminds me of home, because it's ginormous. Our playgrounds back at home, yeah, they're ginormous like this. And it has pink. My favorite color is pink. Did I ever tell you my favorite color is pink? Because when I was little, my mommy bought me this cool thing that was pink. I love pink.
I guess this looks like the memory verse, but I don't even know what it is.
Okay, we've made our decision. Back to you, Roxy.
All right, Tia kids, we are back. The judges have spoken, and we're gonna find out who the winner of our Holly Jolly Kitchen competition is. This week, it is Kern, because his gingerbread house was so wonderful, the judges really didn't know what it was. Kern, how are you feeling?
I feel fantastic. All the hard work, a little bit of sweat, paid off. Yes.
The judges never mentioned any taste of sweat, so we'll just take it from there. Congratulations, Kern. It's time to go to the wall of gifts to pick out your prize. Hey, CF kids, it's Roxy, and I am back at our wall of gifts with our week 2 winner from our Holly Jolly Kitchen competition. It's Kern. How are you feeling, Kern?
I feel fantastic, Roxy, and I am ready to pick one of these gifts.
All right, go ahead and pick out your gift, and don't forget, whatever you choose will be going into the mystery prize for this month's CF Kids Challenge winners.
That is exciting. Now, which gift should I get? They look so amazing. Only get one, right? Just one?
Yes. How would you get 2?
This one looks like a hat. You guys know how much I love hats, so.
All right, let's see what our kids are gonna win.
Oh, mac and cheese candy canes, yes. More candy canes, thank you.
Okay, that's right, CF Kids. If you complete your challenge card for this month, you will get a mystery prize that will contain these very interesting candy canes. Take these, Kern. Yes. Okay. All right. Congratulations to our week 2 winner. Kids, you have to be back for our 3rd and final round of our Holly Jolly Kitchen competition to see who will win the last round of our gingerbread house competition. Kern, are you feeling confident about next week?
So confident.
Gabby won the week before, so Michael, this round is on you. Don't forget, kids, we will see you back next week. Bye, guys.
All right, guys, hurry up and connect. I want to share these awesome announcements with my friends.
Hi, Bruce.
Hey, guys, I've been waiting for you. What happened?
Well, Joy took forever fixing her hair and—
No way. I've been waiting for you, but you've been zooming around the house chasing that ball.
All right. Mind that, we need to plan our Christmas party. But first, I have some news to tell you.
What's the mystery prize for this month, Bruce? A personalized CF Kids ornament?
I bet it's a sparkly princess crown.
You will have to watch every weekend to find out what we will have for our mystery prizes as we reveal them on our Wall of Gifts.
What? That sounds so cool.
But don't forget that in order to get that spectacular, amazing, wonderful mystery prize, you will have to complete your challenge cards. Do you remember the challenges?
Yep. Watch CF Kids online at one of our campuses or at home, learn my memory verse, and invite 3 friends to watch at home or come to church using these cool door hangers that your parents can find at cfmiami.org/parents.
Dash, don't forget the family mission, love gifts. This month, we get to buy a Christmas gift for a child. I can't wait to go pick it out and drop it off at church. It will be so sparkly.
You guys are right. If you complete 5 of the 7 challenges, that's right, it's a little different this month. Complete 5 of the 7 and ask your parents to send in the challenge card to cfkids@cfmiami.org. You will get a mystery prize.
Let's dash on over and tell our parents.
Wait, there's one more thing. Since it's the most wonderful time of the year and we have so much to celebrate, invite a friend and join us at one of our campuses for snow, cookies, and an amazing Christmas story. Or you can cozy up on the couch with some hot chocolate and watch our CF Kids Christmas Eve spectacular show from home. This special episode will air at 5 p.m. We look forward to celebrating the birth of Jesus with you this Christmas Eve.
This sounds like it will be so amazing and sparkly and fun. Wow, I need to tell my parents and call my friends and invite them right now. Oh, and I can invite my teacher and the cashier at the store and my neighbor. Oh my gosh, there's so many people to tell. I gotta go. Bye, Bruce.
Bruce, I better go help Joy. She seems to be on a mission. Okay, bye.
I'm getting hungry. Snack time for me. Bye, guys.
I know we probably won't have a gingerbread bake-off at the Christmas Eve Spectacular, but it was so much fun to decorate those gingerbread houses today.
Absolutely, Gabby, and so delicious.
Michael, stop eating the roof of my gingerbread house.
Whoops. Well, Gabby and CF Kids, I think this house needs some repairs. But it's been such a great time together, and learning that God can do anything is a great reminder for all of us.
That's right. No matter what you may be facing, we can know that God can do anything. So let's pray together, friends.
Let's pray.
Lord, we thank you so much for who you are. We thank you that you are a God that can do anything. No matter what we may be facing, no matter what we may be going through, God, we can trust that you can do anything. Just like how you did a miracle through sending us Jesus to be our Savior. God, we thank you so much for who you are. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Bye, CF Kids!
All right, well, I'll be taking this
for repair. No, don't take my gingerbread house anyway. Michael, give me my gingerbread house!